Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage, Tab Benoit.
All right! Let's have some fun!
Bye.
I'll be here for a whole 2 days. What's that? Okay, so you're already going for the request thing, right? That's the way I like it. I like to know what I'm dealing with right off the bat. So please do yell for requests. We are here for y'all because it is absolutely beautiful to have people to play for. Beautiful, man. I got all my carpentry shit done. I'm pretty good at it too, boy. I use the Pythagorean theorem and all that shit. Hey. My math teacher would have been proud. I was A squared plus B squared equals C squared all over that shit. In the carpentry term, they call that 3-4-5 in that bitch. And good Lord, I learned it. But that's the only piece of algebra that I did use practically in my life. That's why I'm a musician, because I was not good at math. But I'm pretty good at making noises. So let's make this one. All up and down. feeling good. I'm feeling a little frisky. So let's have some fun. At least I will. And y'all can sit there and watch it. For one low, low price. Isn't that a beautiful thing? I love my job. It's not really a job. This is the good part. The hard part, the job part, is getting here. They put this side of Florida way too far away from Louisiana. Let's just flip it like this and put it over there. Here we go. It's in the key of G, in case that means anything to y'all, which it probably does not. But it does help Corey out tremendously. Corey on the bass. On the drums back there from New Orleans, the one and only Terence Higgins. Can you believe it? Me either.
Can you believe it?
All right, here we go. Key of G. I'm going to start it off like I do with all the other songs. That way everybody knows almost what to do. That's the way I like it. I don't want to know exactly what to do. I just want to know almost. That way there's room for improvement. There's always room for improvement. So I'm going to work on some of that improvement right now. That's right. I'm practicing for tomorrow. Not that tomorrow's going to be any better. Just every day I'm practicing for tomorrow. This is the best show you're going to see right now in this room tonight. That's right. Unless you're watching somebody else on YouTube as I speak. I got earplugs in right now. I'm listening to Lady Gaga. That's right. Can't even hear my own shit. I'm joking. I'm not listening to anything except this.
Thank you.
Thank y'all. That stuff kind of knocks the guitar a little out of tune, you know? I don't think the guy that invented the guitar meant it to be played like that. But that's okay, because I'm not a guitar player. I'm a drummer. That was handed a guitar because I was too loud. The person that said I was too loud was my mama. When I was very small, but I was starting to get bigger. I was starting to grow into the size of my head. That's right. My head has been this size since I was 4 years old. I was one of them kids. Like if you put a helmet on me, you could barely see my legs. I'd like to think it was because it was full of brand new fresh brains. But then I grew into my head and now I look almost normal. Except for this hair. Thank you so much. Because I really don't know what to do with it. I've never had hair like this. That's right. I mean, can you believe all of this was on the inside of my head? I still have a hard time wrapping my head around that. I can think so much clearer now, though. Because I don't have all of this hair tickling my brain like it was before. It's all on the outside, where it can hang out in the breeze. That's a unique experience for me, because I never had hair that moved. I was a guy that could go in a boat at 80 miles an hour and go right back to the dock the way I looked when I left. I know that because I took Dan Rather out on my boat one time. We were doing a story. This is not a joke. It's very real. And when I told him how fast we'd be going, the producer sprayed his hair down with some very powerful shit. I just called it the Dan Rather spray. I have no idea what was in there, but they sprayed his hair down like with a can and a half. And 80 mile an hour, no problem. He looked like he was sitting in a studio. As far as his hair goes, his face was moving all over the place, but his hair was still. If they'd have sprayed his face down, it probably wouldn't have moved so much. But the man was 80 years old. I didn't want to give him a heart attack, so I only got him up to 87. At the end of the interview, though, I asked him, "Hey, Dan, where y'all get that spray from? Because when a hurricane comes, if we took that and we sprayed all the coastline down with that Dan Rather spray, not a blade of grass would move. Because I had Dan Rather at hurricane speeds, like Category 2. He would not tell me, because he didn't want me to deplete the supply. But I always have that story. And a few others that I'll tell y'all later. But right now I want to play some music. Even though I'm doing my jokes in the key of E, this song is not. Thank you, Corey, for that interjection.
It didn't work. You're still in E.
All right. So here's a song that I requested. Nice. It's Since I'm so close to me, I can hear myself perfectly.
I don't know how with all that hair.
All right. Why am I checking the wind? I don't know, but here we go. It's a song that I wrote some time ago, and I hope I remember it. Wait, maybe I didn't write this one. Okay. Seems like I always remember the ones that I didn't write better than the ones that I did. So let me try. The earth can shake. The sky come down, the mountains all fall to the ground, but I will fear none of these things. Shelter below, underneath your wing, dark waters rise, the thunder pounds, the wheels of war are going round. and time no more shall be. I say, oh death, where is your stain? Shelter me, Lord, underneath your wing. Shelter me, Lord, underneath your wing. Shelter me, Lord, underneath your
thank you. Thank you.
was time to move on. So won't you please, please forgive me, baby, and let's walk side by side, Lord, and fill in the darkness. Oh, between you and I. What else? What else y'all want to hear? Okay. You can't yell for stuff that I played already. I'm sorry, maybe you were in the bathroom when I played that one, but I can't do it again. Okay. All right, some of those I remember. One more time for the guys in the band. Y'all ready? But three of us making all this noise. Is Al over there? Listen, can we add a fourth guy to make some noise with us? There you go. Come jam on the organ with us, man. The thing is, it's sitting there and it's just spinning and looking at us like I'm running. Come on, man. Let's have some fun. Yes.
So what's happening up in here?
Thank y'all. Thank you for having us back, man. And being one of the first guys out here that hiring touring acts, you know, that's a big thing, man. There's a lot of bands out there that ain't touring, you know. But I don't play to computer screens. I don't like to get applause from an emoji. This with some squiggly lines around it ain't doing shit for me. Pretend this is moving back and forth. I like to hear y'all do it live. That's music for me. That's like... That's why we don't just sit at home and play for ourselves. Because, hey, we love music, you know, but there's a different thing when you're playing it with other people. Not for other people, but with y'all. I always feel like we're playing with y'all. Because y'all bring in something with you. Like, I don't sound like this at home. First of all, I ain't got a microphone, so I'm not as loud. But just as annoying. That's why I always end up playing in the woods. Man, the squirrels and the rabbits and the snakes love me. I love you back. I know y'all just being nice, but thank you so much. Oh, we come out here for y'all, man. This is between us. That's why I'm listening to all the requests. And I always do, and I don't just play through a set list of stuff. I don't. Okay, I sure wish we got the title right. Because that would have been a great segue. But you flubbed it at the end. So sorry. You should have got your phone out and looked at it. I'm just messing with you, baby. I know what you meant, but it's just funny that people still get the names wrong. Sometimes people just pull out words in the middle of a song and expect me to know which one it is. She got it wrong too, so don't feel so bad. She's over here, play New Orleans woman. She's over there, play lady from New Orleans. None of that is fucking right. There you go. One person got it. Somebody's listening to something else while I'm playing. But thank you, y'all are requesting. I'm glad three of y'all want the same song, even though one of y'all knows what it is. That's pretty good. That's not bad.
What is it?
One out of three ain't bad. Wasn't that a song? Oh, it's two out of three. Yeah. I must have heard that when I was at Walmart, that meatloaf song.
Is that why you cooked meatloaf on a bus the other day?
No, but that would make sense.
It's pretty good.
The meatloaf song, that doesn't mean that's one of Meatloaf's songs. That means that's a song that you heard while you were cooking meatloaf. Dude. Remember that Meatloaf song? Yeah, I think it was Elton John.
Dude, stop it.
It ain't my fault. I get shit stuck in my head and I can't get rid of it, y'all. I'm releasing right now. For like 7 days, I had Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds stuck in my head, but it was the Elton John version. Isn't that weird? That's only me, I guess. And every now and then, like something stupid gets in there that I can't get rid of. Like I really never needed to know, that Taylor Swift was really never, ever, ever getting back together with that dude. But I go to Walmart, so I hear stuff that I don't want to hear. And I see stuff that I don't want to see. And I smell stuff that I do not want to smell. And if you're using the basket, you touch stuff you never wanted to touch.
There you go with that E again.
There goes that E. All of my jokes are so much better in E. Because if I move to G, doesn't work. Good thing we're in E, because the next song happens to be in E.
Sweet.
Bring me. Thank y'all so much. I mean, I love y'all. And I know a lot of y'all have been coming to see me for a long time. How many are new tonight? How many newcomers we got? All right. Thank y'all. All the way from what? Orlando. I don't keep canceling shit. I never cancel. Put it this way, if the gig cancels and my name is on it, something really happened if I canceled it. I mean, I don't even use the transmission went out routine anymore, you know? I will rent a car. I will jump on the back of a moped. I will take a rickshaw, whatever it takes. I will get here. If my name is on that sign, I'll do my best to get here always. I wish I could understand everything y'all was saying. Probably earlier in the night, maybe. I don't know if it's y'all lips that are getting numb or mine. Either way, num, num, num. Y'all wanna hear some more music? Yeah. Fuck, me too. I just want to come out and hang out with y'all. Y'all look like y'all having so much fun out there. I'm like jealous. Look, Al makes us stand in this little cubicle all night. He's not even here. Look, I'm talking about him.
Is he not?
Oh, he's here somewhere.
Oh, he's here.
He's always here.
He's got to count the money. One more time for the guys in the band, man. These are my friends from way back. Corey on the bass. Terence on the drums. You want to get Josh up here with us? Come on, let's get Josh Garrett up here. Josh is another old friend from down home in Louisiana, y'all. Hey, Al, you want to join in?
There's 12 of them, dude. There's actually a bunch of other ones, too, but we understand. We understand. I'm going to get them up after
this. I wanted to do this one for the three people that requested it.
For the women. You're welcome.
And for the ones that got it wrong and the ones that got it right. I'm going to do it for y'all. Like the JP Soars, y'all.
Where did JP come from? He snuck up on us, y'all. Truly a Whiskey Bayou review, y'all. Mr. Josh Garrett, JP Soars, Whiskey Bayou review, y'all. Give it up.
Came out of the darkness. Into the light. He walked among us and nobody knew. Plus, I just like saying mungus. Yesterday I set a trap and I caught among us.
Yeah, you're right, Bob.
I'm just having fun. I don't know why y'all came here.
It's Monday. That's why.
And Monday rhymes with
fun day.
Fun day. Thank God that for that.
We usually don't play on Mondays. This is really strange.
Okay. I'm gonna play a song that everybody up here knows. It's gonna be a unique experience.
Hey, Al.
Oh, even Al knows this one. Al. Give it up, Al. And all the people here that put the fucking biscuit on, y'all. It takes a village. And they all love the blues, and they all love live music. So, you know, that's why we can continue to do this. I mean, Al owns the place. He loves live music so much, he just leaves his shit set up. First of all, it's heavier than most furniture that y'all have in your house anyway, so it's like, hey, help me move my B3. Oh, that's okay. I'd rather do plumbing.
Take your hat off. I'll take mine off. Ready? Same time.
Here we go. In the key of A, Al.
Sure?
And JP.
Okay,
all right. And Josh. And Corey. Terence, and everybody here tonight, everybody, the whole fucking Biscuit family. Can't I'm
Thank you.